Long keeping shoulder external rotation is essential to trigger ultra rapid shoulder internal rotation. Only two players, Federer and Djokovic, shows ultra rapid shoulder internal rotation. Shoulder external rotation is when you rotate your shoulder outward from the center of your body. Contrary to this, shoulder internal rotation is when you rotate your shoulders inward toward the center of your body. Long keeping shoulder external rotation allows rapid shoulder internal rotation to generate high speed of ball. Batting and golf swing are the motion how you use your two hand. However, forehand stroke is the motion here you use just your own hand, like baseball pitching. If you wanna swing like Victor, Djokovic, Federer, Murray, and Nadal, you must move away from the traditional hitting concept using two hands. Every time I practice Djokovic and Federer forehand strokes, I am surprised to see my dominant arm having ultra-rapid shoulder internal rotation. I want you to feel this ecstatic feeling too. This motion is shoulder internal rotation. Djokovic is hitting a ball by using whole body rotation. His dominant arm is just passively following the movement of whole body rotation. Even at the point of ball impact, his dominant hand is passively following the movement of whole body rotation. To achieve rapid shoulder internal rotation like professional pitchers, hip turn and upper body turn must take place before the shoulder internal rotation. That is, whole body movement must lead the throwing motion, and the dominant arm is passively following the body movement. Even though conscious use of hand and wrist take place just before the ball release, you can see this hand and wrist motion and looking at Nadal and Murray's forehand strokes. I'll cover this subject later. Look at this Federer motion. Shoulder internal rotation begins just before the ball contact and just after the ball contact. The shoulder external rotation starts from this position. The external rotation ends at this point. At this point, he starts shoulder internal rotation. His shoulder internal rotation ends at this point, and then follow through takes place. You can see Federer's shoulder internal rotation. You can see Djokovic's shoulder internal rotation. Let's look at Wawrinka's forehand stroke. He shows slow shoulder internal rotation and wide motion of shoulder horizontal adduction. Slow shoulder internal rotation means slow change of direction of racket. So, racket head acceleration at the ball contact point is inevitably low, and so intense shoulder horizontal adduction is needed to generate a strong impact. Intense shoulder horizontal adduction need more physical strength and more excessive physical movement. So, with this movement, it is easy to get tired and get injured. Djokovic is so different from Pavlinka. He shows very short shoulder horizontal adduction and ultra left shoulder internal rotation. He generates ultra acceleration of racket head at the contact point. He just use whole body rotation with completely loose right arm. He generates a strong impact with effortless whole body rotation. Let's see pedal motion. He shows very short arm of shoulder internal rotation, that is, ultra rapid shoulder internal rotation. Ultra acceleration of racket head at the contact point.
Because he doesn't.
I mean,
he
without
plays,
knowing what Djokovic is going to do.
Yeah.
Let's take Dimitrov's point stroke as an example for comparison. He shows very long-term shoulder internal rotation and intense shoulder horizontal adduction. His swing is very physical, very intense, easy to get tired. You can see long-lasting slow shoulder internal rotation. Tsitsipas also depends more and more on physical strength. Tsonga also shows slow shoulder internal rotation and intense shoulder horizontal adduction. His swing is very physical. TFO also shows slow shoulder internal rotation and intense shoulder horizontal adduction. His swing is so physical, injury prone. Medvedev also shows intense shoulder agent adduction and slow shoulder internal rotation. His swing is also physical. DM also shows intense shoulder agent adduction and slow shoulder internal rotation. It seems also physical. Let's look at Djokovic forehand stroke. Now you can see how Djokovic and Federer swing are so different.
To change direction and go down the line, and it's actually doing really well in these forehand cross court.
Chinook pose is almost everything you need to achieve Djokovic, Federer, Nadal, and Murray forehand strokes. I recommend you to study on this pose. This pose is essential for you to keep shoulder horizontal abduction and shoulder external rotation as long as possible. You can easily achieve forehand stroke like Big Four by using this Chinook pose.